Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum everyone. Hope you all are doing good. Do subscribe, like and follow the channel. So the topic that we are going to discuss today is collaboration/communication diagram. A collaboration diagram, also known as communication diagram, is actually an illustration of the relationship and interactions among the software objects in the Unified Modeling Language, aka UML. These diagrams can be used to portray the dynamic behavior of a particular use case and define the role of each object. Diagram notations. So here we have classes and instances. So for different UML elements such as class, actor, instances or unnamed instance, we have a graphic symbol for it. So for example, right here, this particular cell is representing a class. This colon at the beginning of the cell with an underlined is representing an instance, and this particular underlined name and then colon and then cell is representing a named instance. So how we can illustrate a link in the UML collaboration diagram, or in other words the communication diagram? So right here I have two of instances, one for of post and the other one is of cell. Of course they are non-named instances, so I have a link between them right here. The link's direction is shown by this arrow, and the link has a call function or a operation or a method call, that is add payment, cash tendered, and one is the sequence of it. So in a link is a connection path between two objects, one and the other. It indicates some form of navigation or some type of visibility between the object is possible. More formally, a link is an instance of an association. So that means the object of the post class can call a method addPayment of the sale class by passing it a parameter of cash tendered. Remember, in system sequence diagram, we had a whole sequence of a particular use case of a particular method call or an operation, but in UML collaboration or communication diagram, we only represent the sequence with 1, 2, or 3, and 4 by numbering them. So the major difference between the SSD, the system sequence diagram, and the collaboration diagram is this, that in collaboration diagram, you can have multiple messages at a single line by representing their numbers, that is 1, 2, and 3. But in SSD, you have to have different lines for each message. Messages. So right here, this is another example. This per one single link is having different messages, and all the messages are represented with a sequence 1, 2, and 3. Each message between objects is represented with a message expression and a small arrow indicating the direction of the message. So that means this particular message is being passed from post to sale. Message syntax. So a message syntax is very simple. It has a return type, then the message name. So the message name here is add payment, and then the parameters. So here the parameter is cash tendered, and then the return type of the message. However, little variation is accepted in the diagram. So this is a message which is flown from post to sale. Parameters. So right here, I have mentioned the parameter whose name is amount, and the parameter type is money. And it is flown from post to sale. The direction is represented by this parameter right here. Similarly, the return value is represented here. So TOT is the return value of this message, that is the total, and the return value type is integer. So that means this TOT tot is a return value whose type is integer, and the direction of this message is from post to sale, represented by this particular arrow. And of course, this one is representing the sequence. Iteration. So the iterations in the UML collaboration or communication diagram are represented by a star sign after the sequence number. So here one star represents that this message is an iterative message. Here the recurrence values are omitted from the transition, but here we have mentioned the recurrence values, that is I is 1 to 10. So that means this particular message will be called 10 times depending upon the value of the I. Implementation. So here this is an iterative message. So this I is 1 to 10 and message 2, and here on 2 is also a recurrence. iterative and I is 1 to 10 and message 3 will be flown. So here we have a message 1 implementation. So basically here on the link we have mentioned a slight bit of the implementation. Message 1 gets us to this particular A and then this first, and then this will be called in an iterative manner. So we have coded them something like this, message 1, and its body will contain a for loop that goes from I1 to 10, and then message 2 first is being called, and then the message 3 will be called. So here we have a list collaboration diagram example. So message 1 gets us to class A, and then message 2 will be called, and because it's 1, so then the message 3 1.1 will be called, then message 4 will be called, then 2.1 message 5, and then the message 6 will be called, and so on. So what's the difference between the sequence and collaboration diagram? As we have seen it first, the basic difference is that in collaboration diagram we can represent different messages on a single line or link, but in sequence diagram we mention them on separate links. So here message 2 and message 3 calling is represented by separate links, but here message 2 and message 3 calling is represented on a single link with a sequence number. The other differences could be the sequence diagram strength is that sequence diagram readability is greater than the communication diagram. The reason is because in sequence diagram the identification of the sequence is easy, whereas in collaboration or communication diagram it's difficult to identify the sequence of the messages. The second one is the sequence diagram extends consumes the horizontal space, whereas the communication diagram is much more easy to manage the space in two dimensions. It's flexible in two dimensions, but it's difficult to see the sequence in the communication diagram. Hope this lecture has helped you to understand the basic concepts and the notations of the communication and the collaboration diagram, the similarities and dissimilarities of the collaboration and the system sequence diagrams. If you have any queries or topic requests, please feel free to comment them. Do subscribe, like, and follow the channel to get more interesting lectures. Allah Hafiz.